Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Mr. Taylor, this should be easy because I'm going to use a lot of your words from the previous deposition as we go forward. In your deposition, you spoke of support for Ukraine and its relationship to the United States and how much you support that. In 2014, you, and I'm quoting this, urged Obama administration to provide lethal defensive weapons in order to deter further Russian aggression. Did the Obama administration provide lethal weapons?
No, sir.
They provided MREs and blankets and things like that. In your deposition, you also said President Obama's objection was because it might provoke the Russians. And in fact, you testified in your deposition that the Obama administration didn't have a good argument since Russia had already provoked and they have invaded Ukraine. Is that correct?
That's correct, sir.
It's a shame he didn't take the advice of a combat veteran like you, sir. Someone who understands what deterrence provides, because a lot of Ukrainian lives could have been saved if he had taken your advice. In your deposition, you said, and I quote, happy, you were happy with Trump administration's assistance, and it provided both lethal and financial aid, did it not?
It did, sir.
And you also stated that it was a substantial improvement, is that correct?
That's correct, sir.
So now we're providing javelins, which kill Russian tanks. MREs and blankets do not do that. Today you said, I was beginning to fear that the long-standing U.S. policy of strong support for Ukraine was shifting. I have a little trouble with long-standing based on what we just talked about, because it wasn't really long-standing strong support. It seems to me the strong support came with this administration. Would you agree with that, sir? Unless you consider MREs and blankets strong support, I wouldn't call it long-standing.
The long-standing that I'm referring to there, Dr. Wenstrup, is the long-standing political support, economic support, and increasing military support.
Well, certainly that strong support came from Congress, but it didn't come from the previous administration as compared to what this administration has decided to do. The strong support came with this administration, not the Obama administration. And maybe now we understand what President Obama meant when he told Russian President Medvedev that he'd have more flexibility after his election. Maybe that flexibility was to deny lethal aid to the Ukraine, allowing Russia to march right in and kill Ukrainians. Again, in your deposition, you urged the Obama administration officials to provide lethal defensive weapons to Ukraine in order to deter further Russian aggression. And now they have that under this administration, don't they, Mr. Ambassador?
They have the javelins, yes, sir.
Thank you.